Hello. In this follow-up tutorial for my ESPHome OLED thermostat project, if you haven't seen it, check out the link here or in the video description. I'll show you how I voice control them using Alexa and Node Red. Not only can I turn them on and off and set the temperature, but I also have these commands. And these set the thermostat based on the current temperature of the room. So on my desk here, I've got three Alexa devices. I've got the living room, one from the kitchen, and this one's from the bedroom. I've also got a couple of thermostats. This one's the living room, this one's the kitchen, and the bedroom one is behind me. And you can see all three home assistant thermostats are showing up here. So living room, kitchen, and then right over there is the bedroom. Now I'm using the mute buttons here to mimic me being in each room. Obviously in reality, they won't hear each other. So let's walk into the living room. Alexa, turn on thermostat.
You got it. Your living room thermostat has been set to 20.
So as you probably heard, it knew which thermostat to control, the living room in this case, and has set that to 20. So if I want to change the temperature of the thermostat, I can say this. Alexa, thermostat 25.
Sure. The living room thermostat has now been set to 25.
So there you go, I've got audio feedback, the thermostat's changed. So let's leave the living room and walk into the kitchen. Alexa, I'm hot.
No worries. Your kitchen thermostat has been set to 24.7.
So using the I'm hot command, it reads the current temperature of the room, then splits the lower and upper limits to 2 degrees below and 2 degrees above and activates the cooling mode. So let's leave the kitchen and walk into the bedroom. Alexa, I'm cold.
You got it. Your bedroom thermostat now set to 28.9.
And the I'm cold command does something similar. It takes the current temperature, adds 2 degrees to the lower limit, and adds 4 degrees to the upper limit. Now, because it's so damn hot in here and the thermostat only goes up to 30, that's gone off scale. But you get the idea. Alexa, thermostat 20.
No problem. The bedroom thermostat is turned to 20.
Alexa, turn off thermostat.
No worries. The bedroom thermostat is changed to off.
So as you can see, I've got a few voice commands, and depending on which room I'm in, it sets the thermostat in that room to the appropriate command. And of course, obviously, all these still work regardless of what room I'm in. So yeah, that works. So the first thing you'll need to set up, if you haven't already, is obviously Alexa, and also you'll need the last called Alexa sensor. I've done tutorials for both of these. You'll find links to those up there in the top right, and they're also in the video description. So on the Alexa media devices, you can see here I've got bedroom dot, kitchen dot, and living room dot. And also in the entities, you can see I've got bedroom, kitchen, and living room thermostats. These names are quite important as they need to match the room to the thermostat. So when adding a new Alexa device and a new thermostat, just make sure that these naming conventions are followed, and my Node-RED code will pick these up automatically for you. Now that we've got our Alexa devices and our thermostats named and placed in each room, we need to set up Node-RED. So this is my current setup, and basically all you need is a new flow called thermostats and to download this JSON file from my GitHub. Again, link in the description for that. Once you've downloaded it and unzipped it, just simply drag this into here. Now mine's going to tell me that there's duplicates, but that's okay. Now everything is set up for you. I've done all the heavy lifting and all the coding. The only thing you'll need to change is in here, set your server to your instance of Home Assistant, and the same for the set temperature and the speak payload. Once done, hit deploy. And ask one of your Alexa devices to search for devices. So she'll go ahead and do that, and she should find these 5 thermostat devices. And that's it. That's all you need to do in Node-RED, just those few steps. Like I say, I've done all the heavy lifting for you. I've done all the coding for all of these and set them all up. So for instance, in here, there's quite a bit going on, but you don't need to worry about any of that. Everything's done for you. It's all set up, ready to go. for the responses that Alexa comes out with. This one here is the feedback for most of the commands. So basically the way this works is when it's invoked, it'll pick one entry from this array here. Then it will, from the second array, it will pick one of those. And I've just got two here that are your. Then it will say the room name, add the word thermostat to it. So for example, bedroom thermostat. Then the next line picks up one of these. So is now, whatever. And then the last one is set to, is turned to, etc. And then finally, the temperature that it's set to. The other one is used for the status. So basically, this pulls in the thermostat, gets the current temperature from it, and then goes through another set of random sentence creation. So the first line, it'll pick up one of these. So the temperature is, it's currently, etc. To that, it will add one of these. So the thermostat is set to, or the current mode is, etc. To that, it will add the current state of the thermostat. So whether that's heat, cool, on, off, etc. Little comma. So there's a slight pause before it says, and is set to, etc, etc. And then to that, it will add the attribute of the target low temperature and then return the whole thing as a message. And both of these spit out a payload, which goes into here. That payload is then read out using the message. And the target there, again, is the last Alexa state, which is the Alexa device that you spoke to. In order to get the I'm hot, I'm cold, I'm warm enough commands and not have to say turn on thermostat, etc., we just use routines for that. So if I show you in mine, I've got several routines made. I've got one there for room temperature. Here's my I'm warm enough. There's my I'm hot, I'm cold. All we need to do for one of these routines is we add a new one. When this happens, voice. And here we type in what you need to say to trigger this routine. So let's say it's too hot in here. Then up here we go to next. And then the action is going to be the too hot command. So we'll add an action. Scroll down to smart home, all devices. And then I'm going to scroll down and find thermostat hot. From there, I want to power. On is by default. Click next. Click save. It'll take a little while for the routine to do its thing. So now with that done, all I need to say is, Alexa, it's too hot in here. And whichever device I'm speaking to and its connected thermostat, they'll set the thermostat based on the room temperature, set it to a cool mode, and adjust the thermostat so cooling is initialized. And then the same thing with the others. So room temperature, that just switches on the status. Obviously hot turns the hot on. And of course, cold activates the cold node. Like I say, those are these nodes here in Node Red. The thermostat, you don't need a routine for that because you'll basically be saying set the thermostat to, and that comes in as a percentage here, and on off as well. So turn off thermostat, turn on thermostat. That's a basic command, so we don't need any routines for that. One final thing that you need to consider, this last Alexa sensor takes a moment for it to update in Home Assistant. There's little that can be done about that as it takes time for the commands to go out and back in again. So just remember to leave a pause between saying Alexa and issuing the command. For me, just waiting for the start sound seems to be enough, but your mileage may vary. So experiment with that and let everybody else that's using this know as well. As always, it'll be great to hear your feedback in the comments below, or if you have any questions or you get stuck. I do my best to address everyone when I can, so if you need help and I'm free, I'll do my best to help you out when I can.
Well, I hope this video was helpful with your projects. Please do share it so others can find it as well. I upload videos whenever I can, so subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified. That's it. Thanks for watching.